My name is Tom Miller. I am a software engineer here at Boston Dynamics. I've been at Boston Dynamics for about 11 and a half years. I really liked playing video games. I liked Super Mario Bros. 3 and SimCity, and I guess I wanted to know how to do that kind of stuff. For college, I studied computer engineering. I knew I wanted to do something with computers, and then decided computer engineering was fun, and then decided robotics looked like a lot of fun from there. Day-to-day at Boston Dynamics is usually working on the application programming interface. It's all the code that you would use to tell Spot what to do. And usually I'm writing software or writing tests for that software, but sometimes I'm actually running the robot and making sure that everything works the way I expect it to. How many robots have you worked on at Boston Dynamics? Oh man, okay. I've worked on Rex, technically, when I first started. I've worked on LS3, I worked on Petman, I've worked on a lot of different versions of Atlas. I've worked on the prototype for Handle, and now I'm also working on Spot. So I guess I'd call that six-ish. How do you program the robot? I have a work laptop, and I set it up with my favorite editors and programming languages, and then I write the code there, and I build it sometimes on my laptop, and then load it up onto the robot and see what the robot does. There are a lot of different ways to test a robot. We have unit tests where you test just a little bit of code, and you can test that on just the inputs and outputs to your one little bit of code. We also have simulation tests where you can run your code on a simulated robot, and that simulates everything to the actual interaction of the robot on the ground. And then you need to actually test on the real robot. What kind of programming languages does Spot use? Spot uses C++ and Python and a little bit of other languages, but those are the two main ones. Can Spot learn changes in pre-programmed routes in real time? Yes, you want Spot to be able to walk a route, but if something happens to be on that route, you don't want Spot to get stuck. So it will go around the object, and sometimes it can take very long paths around something, like a door is closed. So if the path is blocked, it will try to go around it. If it still can't go around it, it will ask the operator, like, hey, I'm stuck, can you drive me somewhere else and get me around this obstacle? Or do you want me to return to the dock? Or do you want me to just stop what I'm doing and go on to the next thing? Could Spot play 5v5 soccer against other Spots? How would that work? Not only can they, but they did. When this building was still under construction, we had people get controllers and drive Spots around to play soccer. Well, some version of soccer. It didn't work very well at the time, but you could definitely make improvements. You can either use the programming interface to tell Spots how to move, or you can pick up the controllers that we also sell and then drive Spot around and get it to kick the ball. Can Spot communicate with other Spots? If so, what do they say to each other? Ooh, I like this. Spots can not really talk to each other because the Spot robot is kind of doing what it's told to do. What you can do is you can have one thing, like a laptop, talk to many Spots all at once. And then you could have that laptop say, okay, well, Spot 1 decided to do this, so I'm going to tell Spot 2 to do that. Can Spot play an instrument? Yes, Spot can and has. One of our employees, for their 7-year anniversary and their dog's 6-month birthday, got Spot to basically stomp on a large oversized piano and play the happy birthday song. From what I've understood, Boston Dynamics robots are mostly hard-coded and they don't act with some sort of autonomous intelligence. If this is true, is there space for a person like me, artificial intelligence software oriented, in this field? Absolutely. The robots here also, they are pre-programmed in the sense that they have some software that's a controller telling them how to interpret commands from people or other programs and figure out where to place their legs. So that kind of stuff isn't hard-coded. The robot can also do this thing that we call auto-walk, where you tell it to do a thing, and then that path is programmed into the robot. But the software on the robot will have a set of choices and other actions it can take if something goes wrong. How can I get started with robots? You can do a lot of different stuff to get started with robots. You can just go down to the library and fire up some YouTube videos, or you can find an after-school group of some kind to help you learn with a group, Or you can even get little mini starter kits like a Raspberry Pi or an Arduino and do kind of the physical side of things. Lots of options.
Can I do robotics after studying at a mathematics physics department in high school?
Yes, you can do robotics after studying almost anything. The mathematics and physics will really help you get an understanding for the physical math behind how the robot moves, and that can be really important. So I think that's a great start.
What's the coolest part of working at Boston Dynamics?
The coolest part of working at Boston Dynamics is that it's a bunch of people that really like doing what they do, and that makes a lot of sense because all the robots are really fun to work with. For programming in particular, you get a chance to write some code and then see what that code does in the real world on a thing. And I think that's really cool, especially for programming.